sports and entertainment, never mind having arenas built across the world. But he said we can do this and foist basically a sports culture for the males using a tribal system. We're all tribal to an extent. That's why we even bother to vote for a tribal leader. This is well understood. That's why we're supplied with these leaders. And because the average man was to become more disengaged from his own destiny as the expert class arose, it was decided that the males would get their outlet, basically, gradually becoming helpless as males through sports. Therefore, they'd have a tribal team they could identify with. They could cheer them on as they were winning. In their own personal lives, they were getting nowhere. They were getting disenfranchised, in a sense, as experts took over decision-making for them in all kinds of fields. So this was psychology at use, planned before they even implemented the sports. When radio came along, of course, they used that to the maximum. Sports for the men, soaps basically for the women. And then in came television, as I say, with its alpha state, its hypnotic state. And sure enough, around the 1960s, really, 50s and 60s, it took off. It really, really took off. And men became glued on Saturday nights to the sports shows. A culture industry, which is called by its own the culture industry. The Soviet Union had a department called the culture industry. Their actors and directors were called the cultural leaders. Leaders. Because they would, like a computer, people are like computers, all you have to do is keep giving them new updates every so often, and you can change an entire country or a nation or a block of nations who are all getting the same uploads, upgrades at the same time along certain paths. Today we call it political correctness. Most people want to belong to their peer group. They want to be the same as everyone else when it comes to opinions. In fact, they judge their own personal sanity by bouncing ideas off their neighbors and friends who will answer back and agree on these same topics in kind. It doesn't matter if the topics or what you're given are facts or utter nonsense. As long as everyone agrees at the same time, you'll say, well, I'm sane, and your friends will all agree because they've had the same information given to them.
But they've been programmed. And I'm sad because I know that it's hard for people like that to take an interest, a serious interest in world affairs, to take a serious interest in what their elected officials are doing. And they're not going to be really inclined to study or discover the deception that's being used against them. And so I'm sad because I see all of that in a flash in my mind as being an indication of how easy it is for the masses to be manipulated.
The scientific dictatorship understands what makes human beings tick. They understand our psychology. They've studied it, and they're using it against us. But the minute the public awakens to the fact that there is an agenda to manipulate them, and the second the public realizes that they are being conditioned and controlled, the establishment begins to lose that edge they've got over people. So all I ask viewers to do is to think for themselves and to study public relations, to study advertising, to study propaganda, and to realize how much of it is out there in their daily lives. And then make the decision for yourself. I just want people to think on their own and to not have their decisions and their thoughts and their ideas prepackaged and basically downloaded into them.
If it's on TV and a famous face says something, then it must be true. He doesn't have to show you facts or anything else. You've been brought up with these faces. That's why they keep these guys on television into their 70s and 80s. You've grown up with this father figure who's on television every night at 6 o'clock in your house, in your room, staring right at you. And he's a father figure. Would he tell you a lie? So you naturally never suspect him. And this same man will lead you through new topics. He'll introduce experts on the topics. They'll have the little summary at the end of every talk, and you are now left with the conclusion that's presented to you. You don't arrive at it. It's given to you, and it's good enough for you.
When I was growing up, people were talking on their front porches, neighbors were playing baseball, there were nightly barbecues. You don't see that anymore. We've lost our communities. You drive through neighborhoods, you see the blue glow of television sets. We're losing our humanity. So if you want to rebel against the globalists, the social engineers, start by turning the TV off a few hours a day and actually getting to know your neighbors, getting outside that comfort zone, expanding your horizons. By coming together as communities, by getting to know our neighbors, we defeat the social engineers.
We're programmed today perfectly, just like machines. We tie this in with the Brzezinski. Brzezinski said in Two Ages, now this guy was way up with the NSA. He's a master geopolitician. He admits he works in 20, 50 year periods to do with geopolitics in other countries. But he said himself, the public will shortly be unable to think or reason for themselves. It was meaning by that the form of information that was given to them, the type, the formulas that were in use then in the 1970s. He says eventually they'll be unable to think or reason for themselves. Eventually, he said, they will expect the media to do all their thinking and reasoning for them. Well, that's happened today. That's why people today can't think outside of the programming from television.
Zbigniew Brzezinski, Obama's main foreign policy advisor, talks about how a cult of personality can be artificially manufactured to influence the masses.
In the first months of my administration, to pull our economy... Oh, goodness. Sorry about that, guys. To pull our economy back from the brink, including the largest and most sweeping economic recovery plan in our nation's history.
We're gullible, but we're also willingly gullible. We want a human being, a big daddy, to come along and make everything right for us. And as long as we believe that, we'll always basically get shafted.
In addition to John, sorry, I just noticed that I jumped the gun here. Go ahead and move it up. I'd already introduced all you guys.
It's the presidential reality show. But when it became an Oprah production, it became slick. You don't have a president, you have an actor. They say that politics is show business for ugly people. You got it.
What am I going to tell the president when I tell him his teleprompter is broken? What will he do then?
It's Obama's role to front for the international banking syndicate and to take all the heat for their unpopular agenda. It's his job to convince the American people that the buck actually stops at the White House.
In Brzezinski's book, Between Two Ages, he said eventually we shall put presidents in who will have personality cults. We shall create massive personality cults for these people through the same techniques as Hollywood has used. Obama is that man today.
The globalists, who know that Obama is going to promote their plan, want to make him such a superhero that nobody will question what he's doing. They'll be so preoccupied with who he is, or where he is, or what he's saying, or what he's wearing, or something like that. The idea of making him into a celebrity is very valuable because that way people are less inclined to ask, what is he doing? So that's very useful to these people.
Similar plans of social control have been continuously carried out by operatives of the Ford Foundation, who Obama has worked for over the last 30 years. Many of the strategies used to control populations were originally developed by Edward Bernays, who coined the phrase public relations. Bernays said that if you manufacture an authoritative figure who repeats the same messages over and over, that this will appeal to the masses' subconscious desires.
Yes, we can.
The unwashed masses will helplessly follow the leader and go along with any message they spout.
Yes, we can. Yes, we can. We shall overcome. Yes, we can. Yes, we can.